Hello! Today I'm going to show you how to start a Turtlebot 3 simulation in any computer that you have. A Mac, a Windows, Linux, and in just a few minutes. So let's see how it works. I'm using for this case my Mac computer, is a notebook. And the first thing that we need to do is to go to the ROS Development Studio. In case that you don't have it, you can go to this address, rds.deconstructsim.com, and then you can create an account, a free account. That's the one that I'm using here. So you are here, then you go to your private simulation and projects, and then you start a new project, an empty project. Let's say that this is a Gazebo 7 project, and let's call it Turtlebot 3. Let's create it. And here it is. So here we have this new empty project about Turtlebot 3. And the next thing that we have to do is to launch it. This is going to launch this empty project on ROS Development Studio. Then the next thing that we are going to do is to populate this project with the Git files of the Turtlebot 3. So now this is launching. We don't need the notebook. So let's close it. And here you can see in this tab, we have in the documentation of the Turtlebot 3 that is online, you can see the requirements of the packages that we need to download. Here there are some, but it also requires some others. We are going to do it. It's just very simple Git clone sentences. So let's go for the first one. Here, the ROS Development Studio has boot up the empty project, so we can see an empty simulation here, provided by this shell package. We don't need that, but anyway, it's there for in case that you want to modify. So let's go to the Kantian workspace source, and there let's do the Git clone that is indicated here. So let me copy and paste here. So okay, so far so good. Then should appear here. Yes, Turtlebot 3 simulations. Okay, great. Now, we not only need these Turtlebot 3 simulations Git, but we also need two other Gits that are provided in this link. This is explained here in the documentation. Very, very well created documentation for Turtlebot 3. So, if you avoid all those things, don't worry about it. Just get those Gits. Let's do one by one, just in case there's some problem or whatever arises. So we clone this one. It's about the Turtlebot messages, done. And the other one that is about the Turtlebot 3 main core packages that contains the descriptions of the robot and that the simulation is going to need. So these are heavier packages. We are receiving the objects, and what we are going to do after that is just compile. So the goal is compile and then launch. That's it, nothing more. You will see. We are almost there, and here it is. So let's go down one directory and do the catkin make to compile all the packages. So now all the packages that we have clone from different gates are provided here, and at the same time that they are here, you can update it at any time. So in case that the creators of those packages are updating their gates, you can come to your RDS ROS Development Studio zone, to your Turtlebot 3 simulation, and then update them also. Yes, it's the same as we do in normal development environments that we have in our local machine. So it's just exactly the same, but it's online and you can use any type of computer to develop with ROS. Okay, done. So far so good, then it is. Then one thing that we need to change is a small thing. It's about the launch files, because the launch files in here, this is the shell package. I'm going to delete it because it's confusing me. So we don't need it. So it can stay there or you can delete it. So Those are the ones that I have downloaded, okay? So here, the one launch file that we have to launch is, so I don't remember now. Let me check. Okay, let me check the documentation here. We go back to the simulation. This is the Turtlebot 3 simulation. And then here it's going to indicate me which one is the Turtlebot 3 Gazebo, Turtlebot 3 Empty World. Okay, so that's it. So Turtlebot 3 Gazebo here, Turtlebot 3 Empty World. Okay, so I'm going to open this one. Let me show you on big screen. And then the thing is that launching this requires a variable that is being launched. So at present, we cannot provide this variable to the ROS Development Studio when it's launching it. So we'll have to hard code it, this value here. And that's what I'm going to do. It's just write the burger because I want to launch the burger. You can set the waffle if you want. Okay, so I have modified it, save it, and now I'm ready to launch. So you can press this button here to relaunch the current project that is contains all those files. So you'll see if I press this button here, then I got this one selected by default, but I can go and select any other launch that I have in my packages. The one that I have modified is this one, Turtlebot 3 Empty World Launch. So I select this one and press run. Now, what it's doing is just doing a ROS launch. The system is doing this ROS launch directly. So without having to type, of course. So yeah, you can see here the result, the messages that Gazebo is generating in this console here. We can put it bigger in a larger screen. I'm using a small laptop now with 11 inches, and that is why you can see that screen is very small. But anyway, here we have it. How many minutes was it? So here it is, the Turtlebot 3 simulation using a web browser online with any type of computer. And I think that we can move it if we check here some other commands. Teleop one. So let's copy this one. And of course, once the simulation is launched, I can launch here any other launch files that I want. So I'm launching, for example, the Teleop control. And here it is. Great. So I can, let me organize this in a better way. So we can see here simulation, and let's move it. Robot. Okay, let's move it. So I will press some buttons here, and you see how it is moving, rotating in some direction, faster, slower, and adding linear velocities, so they can do some interesting spins moving around, etc. Okay, you can experience whatever. But as you can see, we got this simulation running in very small times, very short time, sorry. So here it is. This is a very quick example of how you can use RDS, the ROS Development Studio, to set up your system in just a few minutes. No installations, and everything working in any kind of computer. And now you can start developing ROS programs for this robot, of course. Just remember, whenever you finish, just remember to save, okay? So you will not lose your project. So that's all. Thank you very much. And please subscribe to our channel in case that you like this kind of video so we can generate more. And if you have any questions, contact us. We have more details below the description of the video. Thank you very much.